Hello everyone, welcome to Knight vs. Samurai Armor. First up, we're going to be talking about leather. Leather was mainly used by commoners, but it was also used as backing for other types of armor. Leather is animal skin, tanned and hardened, and it was pretty good protection against slashing weapons, not very useful against thrusting weapons. It's pretty light though, and it's very useful as padding if you wore it under some other type of armor, like chainmail. Chainmail is interlocking rings. They were solid rings and riveted rings. A mixture of the two, obviously, because you can't have just solid rings. A lot of times you'll see on TV and historical reenactments, you'll see butted mail. If you see anybody testing weapons against butted mail, you instantly know that video is not worth a darn, because butted mail is not historical. They never used it in battle. They use it these days because it's simple to make. Any idiot can make butted chainmail. But the rings being just pinched together, they don't stay shut, so when they spread or they get hit, they spread apart and the blade goes right in and kills you. I see that as a bit of a disadvantage, really, so if you're going to be wearing anything to battle, you'd want a riveted or solid rings. But there's also scale, or lamellar, which are overlapping plates, much like the scales of a fish. They didn't have chainmail by itself in Japan. They used it mainly as a mix with something else, as a fixture, which, like plate mail, so they'd have solid plates connected with chainmail, but back to scale, it's just overlapping plates. It's very common, or more common in Japan than it was in the West. The West, it did see some use, but it was mostly Asian. Plate mail was, again, mostly Asian, but it did see some usage in the West. What was more common in the West was the coat of plates, which are a bunch of small plates attached to a cotton or leather to hold it all together, since they couldn't fix one big plate at the time. They had many small ones connected together. It was very effective. Very effective. It would stop even the couched lance from strike from a knight, which is where they tuck it under their arm when they're riding on horseback, much like what they do when they're jousting. A ton and a half horse with about 200-pound guy running at you about 30, 35 miles an hour, all of that force on that one point, that is an intense impact. And a coat of plates would stop that. You'd still feel the blow, but you wouldn't get stabbed. You'd probably die anyways from the blunt force, but you wouldn't have a hole in you. And that's about as far as a samurai got. They ended up with the coat of plates, but that's about as strong as their armor was. In the West, they had full plate armor, which is the ultimate armor. Just a big, solid sheet of metal between you and the enemy's stabby weapons. Not much can get through full plate. You gotta have a very significant force. It stops most blunt force, but if you're gonna get through plate, you're gonna want blunt or very strong piercing. Light piercing's not gonna get through. You're gonna need a hell of a hit to get through. Which they usually wore the plate over a cotton or leather Accuton to absorb the blunt impact. I mean, it's strong and it covers pretty much all of the body. The only places not covered by plate were the armpit, the lower region of your torso where your crotch and shit are, the back of your knees, and the inner part of your elbow. The rest of the body was solid plate, and those areas were covered by chainmail, which is very difficult to pierce. They're very small areas, so you're going to have a hell of a time hitting those spots, let alone piercing them. So if you're in full plate, you're, for the most part, invincible, to say the least. You definitely feel invincible. The only problem is, with the helmet, you can't really breathe too well. And you can't see or hear as well because it obstructs your vision. But that's about it. Its total weight for a full plate is about 60 pounds. It's thicker on the head and torso than it is on the arms and legs, so you still have pretty much full mobility, especially after you've trained with it and gotten used to it. So there's no real disadvantage in not having it, or there's no advantage to not having it. So if you can have it, have it. Now the Japanese did employ one other thing that I need to talk about. Well, two, actually. False armor, which they had the plates, mostly all of their armor was covered in lacquer, so you couldn't tell exactly what it was. You couldn't tell if it was leather or steel, and if it looks like armor, you're not going to strike directly at it. So if they had something like that on you, then it'd be pretty useful. But if somebody actually strikes it, then they'll find out it's not really that strong of armor, but if it looks strong, odds are they're not going to go after it. They also had what is called the horo, which is basically a silk parachute worn on their back, which while they're riding full speed on horseback, protects their back from arrows. Lesser arrows, or lower poundage bows, would, especially at longer range, would just bounce off. So it's pretty useful. Slowed him down a little bit because it's a parachute, but very creative. Excuse me. So in terms of armor, it's definitely going straight to the knight. The samurai doesn't have anywhere near as strong a defense. And that's the biggest difference in this battle, is the armor that each side had to face. The Japanese didn't have to face near as powerful armor as the knights did, so their weapons didn't evolve to penetrate that sort of armor, whereas the knights fought against other people in plate armor, so they had to develop weapons to get through plate armor. If you can get through plate armor, you can get through anything below plate armor, at least strength-wise. So that is the main point here. Japanese didn't have the kind of weapons they needed to get through the kind of armor the West has, while as the West has the weapons needed to get through armor much stronger than the Japanese ever had. So that is the big difference. That is why the knight would win if you're going full kit.